My name is Jeremy Schmit. I'm an assistant professor here in the physics department at Kansas State University. So I'm interested in problems about protein aggregation, Alzheimer's, type 2 diabetes, mad cow. These are all caused by proteins that aggregate together. The thing you should imagine here is a pharmaceutical company, and they're developing a protein drug that's designed to go in and target a specific cancer cell. And manufacturing, transportation, storage, this stuff is all very hard on proteins, and at the end of it, you don't want to pull out your tube and find that all your drug is in a white glob at the bottom of the tube. And so I'm trying to figure out what causes proteins to stick together, how do we stop it, how do we cause it in order to make this happen in a more controlled fashion.
Jeremy brings his expertise to really blend in the strengths that we have in condensed matter and soft matter, and going beyond that to bring in to the realm of biological physics.
We ask him, so, you know, why would you want to come to Kansas State University? And he looks down at the floor and he wiggles his head like this and he says, you know, I'm just giddy about the possibilities of the science I could do if I came here. And I'm telling you, when he said that, I got giddy too.
Kansas State's got a lot of really neat stuff going for it. Here in the physics department, we've already got some really interesting colloid work, both on the theory side and on the experimental side.
The experimental efforts are in colloids, aerosols, surface properties of nanoparticles, nanoparticle aggregation, biological physics, nanowires, particle-cell interactions, how protein folds under pressure. Jeremy is very friendly and accessible, both to students and faculty, and I think students will have a great time working with him.
So I'm going to be looking to bring on students very early. You know, this would be a good place for say somebody that's real interested in physics or, you know, molecular function, but at the same time want to keep their opportunities open for a job in the pharmaceutical industry or in biotech fields afterwards.
Jeremy will be good for students because of his youthful enthusiasm. I think more than anything else as a teacher, you want somebody who has an enthusiasm, a passion for their subject. Then maybe the class is hard, who knows what, but if they at least have that, you're willing to follow your teacher wherever he or she may take you.